please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome to the CNBC TV18 special. I'm Shireen Bhan. We'd also like to welcome our viewers of CNBC Awaaz on the program. Exactly 3 months ago, we were here at the headquarters of the Confederation of Indian Industry, partnering with CII, bringing to you the conversation that we had with the Revenue Secretary Hasmukh Adhia on the rollout of the goods and services tax. 3 months down the road, we're back here again at the CII to talk about the possible changes that we could see in the GST regime, the issues that people are facing on the ground, both compliance-related as well as procedural, and what more we can realistically expect in terms of decisions from the GST Council, what the challenges are, what the implementation issues are on ground. We're proud to have with us here, once again, Hasmukh Adhia, the Revenue Secretary. Ms. Adhia, thank you very much for joining us here. We've also got a room full of people representing different sectors here at the CII who will be taking their questions to the Revenue Secretary. Keep tweeting us. Our hashtag is Ask Adhia and GST Town Hall. Use both those hashtags to send us your questions. We'll try and get them addressed here by the Revenue Secretary. Jaisa ki maine kaha ki CNBC Awaaz ke darshak bhi hame join kar rahe hain is special broadcast mein. GST ko lagu kiye hue ab 3 mahine ho chuke hain. Kafi changes dekhi gayi hain. GST Council ne rate mein bhi revision kiye hain aur design mein bhi kafi revision kiye hain. Aur abhi bhi ye ummeed hai ki jaise ki composition scheme hai, usme bhi kuch बढ़ोतरी की जाएगी, उसमें भी कुछ बेहतर करने की उम्मीद है, और ये सब सवाल आज हम हसमुख आदिया जी से पूछेंगे. मिस आदिया, लेट मी स्टार्ट बाय आस्किंग यू माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन बिफोर आई गेट एवरीबॉडी एल्स इन. सर, एज फार एज द रेवेन्यू पिक्चर इज कंसर्न्ड, मिस आदिया, वी सॉ अ नंबर कमिंग इन ऑफ अबाउट 95,000 करोड़ रुपीज एंड देन 92,000 करोड़ फॉर जुलाई एंड ऑगस्ट. गिव मी अ सेंस, सर, इज दिस इन लाइन विद एक्सपेक्टेशंस? इज दिस अ कॉज फॉर कंसर्न, स्पेशली इफ यू लुक एट वॉट the refund picture may look like? What is the revenue picture look like today, sir?
Well, thank you, Shireen. First of all, मैं शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहूँगा जितने भी मीडिया चैनल के द्वारा कोशिश की जा रही है, including CNBC TV18, कि GST को बेहतर बनाने में जो सहयोग दे रहे मीडिया चैनल हमारे साथ, उसके लिए मैं आपका बड़ा शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहूँगा. देखिए, जो आपका पहला प्रश्न है कि जीएसटी का जो रेवेन्यू अभी तक आया है, वेदर वी आर एबल टू मेक एनी सेंस आउट ऑफ इट, आई वुड से नॉट येट, क्योंकि जो भी रेवेन्यू फर्स्ट 2 मंथ्स में आया है उसमें से अधिकतम रेवेन्यू आईजीएसटी में है.
जी.
नाउ इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि आईजीएसटी तो एक तरह से देखा जाए तो इंटरिम काइंड ऑफ ए रेवेन्यू है हमारे लिए. आईजीएसटी रेवेन्यू जो है वो तो इंटरिम टैक्स है. जब तक आईजीएसटी का परिवर्तन सीजीएसटी या एसजीएसटी में नहीं होता है तो न हम उसको स्टेट की इनकम गिन सकते हैं, न सेंटर की इनकम गिन सकते हैं. तो उस तरह से अगर देखा जाए तो हमारे लिए ट्रेंड अभी क्लियर नहीं है, क्योंकि फर्स्ट 2 मंथ्स में सब जैसे पहले था. प्री जीएसटी क्या था कि इंटर स्टेट ट्रांसफर आप करते थे तो आपको कोई टैक्स नहीं बना था, अनलेस यू आर डूइंग इट ऑन इनवॉइस.
राइट.
अगर आप गोडाउन ट्रांसफर कर रहे हैं तो यू डिंट हैव टू पे एनी आईजीएसटी और एनी टैक्स.
ओके.
इट वॉज जस्ट विदाउट एनी टैक्स दैट यू कुड डू गोडाउन ट्रांसफर. नाउ एनी बडी ट्रांसफरिंग गुड्स फ्रॉम वन स्टेट टू अनदर दे हैव टू पे आईजीएसटी.
राइट.
तो आईजीएसटी ज्यादा पे करेंगे शुरू में, लेकिन वो तो इंटरिम टैक्स है. उसके बाद जब वो माल बिकेगा, जब ट्रांसफर होगा तब आईजीएसटी आया हमारे पास, बट जब वो माल बिकेगा तब उसके ऊपर जो टैक्स भरा जाएगा वो हमारे लिए रेवेन्यू बनेगा. तो इसलिए मैं कहूंगा कि अभी तक रेवेन्यू का जो ट्रेंड है वो बड़ा क्लियर नहीं है. हमको कम से कम 4-5 महीना वेट करना पड़ेगा कि ये जो आईजीएसटी का एक्युमुलेशन हो रहा है
जी,
वो कहाँ रुकेगा और उसके बाद कब वो परिवर्तन होगा सीजीएसटी एसजीएसटी में, और नॉर्मल हमारी रेवेन्यू कितनी होगी. दूसरी ये भी वजह है कि कंप्लायंस का जो परसेंटेज है अभी रिटर्न फाइलिंग का वो भी लो है. तो जब तक हम लोगों को वहां तक नहीं पहुंचाए कि भाई अगर आपके कोई ट्रांजेक्शन है, आपका कोई टैक्सेबल इनकम है, तो आपको रिटर्न फाइल करना ही करना है. वो वैसे भी जो भी रजिस्टर्ड है उनको सबको रिटर्न फाइल करना है, लेकिन अभी रिटर्न फाइल नहीं हुआ है तो फिर वो भी एक रीजन है कि हमारा रेवेन्यू का ट्रेंड पता नहीं चलेगा हमको।
तो सर आप कह रहे हैं कि अभी रेवेन्यू का ट्रेंड जो है यू कैनॉट मेक टू मच सेंस ऑफ द नंबर्स दैट हैव कम इन फॉर द मंथ ऑफ जुलाई एंड अगस्त, बट गिव मी अ सेंस ऑफ व्हाट कुड बी दैट बॉल पार्क नंबर दैट वी शुड एक्सपेक्ट दैट वुड गिव अस अ सेंस ऑफ वेदर वेयर ओके और वेदर वेयर इन द डेंजर जोन। व्हाट इज दैट नंबर दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज वर्किंग विद, व्हाट इज योर ओन एस्टिमेट और व्हाट यू वुड रिक्वायर?
देखिए वो एफएम साहब ने अपनी प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में बताया था जब सबसे पहले ये आंकड़े दिए थे कि अगर 14% के हिसाब से स्टेट की 15-16 की इनकम को हमको रीइंबर्स करना है, उनको उतना चाहिए, तो उसके हिसाब से और अगर ये हम ले कि भाई पूरे 12 महीने में डिवाइड कर दे उसको इक्वली,
राइट,
तो एक महीने में कम से कम 43,000 करोड़ इज व्हाट वी नीड।
यस
43,000 करोड़। अब हम लोग जितना स्टेट को मिलेगा उतना ही सेंटर को तो मिलना ही चाहिए ऑब्वियसली, तो बोल पात फिगर ये है करीब करीब।
ओके 43,000 करोड़। सर कंप्लायंस को लेकर
अगर हम ये माने कि हर महीने में इक्वल रेवेन्यू आए, ऐसा नहीं होता है
जी।
कुछ मंथ ऐसे होते हैं जहां लो बिक्री होती है और फेस्टिवल मंथ ऐसे होते हैं जहां ज्यादा बिक्री होती है
जी। कंप्लायंस को लेकर काफी दिक्कतें आई हैं सर, जीएसटी को लेकर भी एक ग्रुप ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स सेटअप हुआ है, सुशील मोदी वो मिनिस्टरियल पैनल लीड कर रहे हैं। जीएसटी को लेकर जो अड़चनें आई हैं वो दुविधा कहीं हद तक सॉर्ट आउट हो गई है, आगे चलकर आपका क्या मानना है कब तक स्टेबलाइज हो जाएगा जीएसटीएन के जो इश्यूज है सर?
देखिए जीएसटीएन के शुरू में कुछ इश्यू थे, लेकिन ये कहना कि भाई जीएसटीएन में अभी भी बहुत सारी दिक्कतें आ रही है वो गलत है। कुछ दिन के लिए कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुआ होगा, और दूसरा एक प्रॉब्लम ये था कि कुछ ऐसी यूटिलिटी जो कि लोग यूज करना चाहते थे वो उपलब्ध नहीं थी सही टाइम पे, ये दो प्रश्न थे। बट मैं समझता हूँ कि पिछले 30-35-40 दिनों में तो कोई ऐसी डिफिकल्टी नहीं आई है जिसमें लोगों को
सर ऑनलाइन काफी लोग पीपल आर ट्वीटिंग अस सेइंग दैट दे हैव इन फैक्ट बीन आस्क्ड फॉर पेनल्टीज इवन व्हेन देयर इज अ दैट दे हैवंट ब्रीच्ड द डेडलाइन सो फार, सो आई एम श्योर सम ऑफ दोस इश्यूज हैव कम टू योर नोटिस एज वेल। एंड द अदर क्वेश्चन दैट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर आस्किंग अस इज दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैड प्रॉमिस्ड सम लीनियंसी, सो व्हाट अबाउट वेविंग द पेनल्टी सर एट लीस्ट टिल मार्च 2018? इज दैट अ कंसिडरेशन एट ऑल?
इट कैनॉट बी अ कंसिडरेशन शेरिन, बिकॉज द मोमेंट वी से कि मार्च तक कोई पेनल्टी नहीं लेंगे जो कंप्लायंस रेट है वो भी गिर जाएगा, कैसे हो सकता है ऐसे? कैसे हो सकता है कि हम ये कहें कि मार्च तक आपको जब मर्जी रिटर्न भरो, जब मर्जी टैक्स भरो, कोई पेनल्टी नहीं लगेगी? ये तो हो ही नहीं सकता।
ओके दैट्स अ वेरी कैटेगोरिकल असर्शन कमिंग इन फ्रॉम द रेवेन्यू सेक्रेटरी। ऑल ऑफ दोस हु हैव बीन ट्वीटिंग मी आस्किंग मी दैट क्वेश्चन, दैट्स अ वेरी क्लियर रिस्पांस देयर फ्रॉम द रेवेन्यू सेक्रेटरी, देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ अ वेवर एज फार एज द पेनल्टी ऑफ द लेट फी इज कंसर्न।
सो आई वॉन्ट से कि पोस्ट फैक्टो वी मे नॉट डू इट, वी विल नेवर डू इट, बट इफ देयर इज एनी वेवर टू बी डन इट हैज टू बी पोस्ट फैक्टो नॉट इमीडिएटली।
ओके
बिकॉज द मोमेंट यू अनाउंस कि भाई हम लोग कोई पेनल्टी नहीं लेने वाले तो आपका कंप्लायंस रेट गिर जाएगा, इसीलिए पोस्ट फैक्टो डिसीजन लिया जा सकता है, बट दैट इज फॉर द काउंसिल टू डिसाइड।
ओके
उसके बाद रिफंड करना पड़े, बट अभी तो बिल्कुल जरूरी है कि लोगों को डिसिप्लिन हम डिसिप्लिन में लाए,
राइट,
कि भाई टाइम से करना है।
सर ऑन कंप्लायंस एंड दिस इज यू रिटन टू स्टेट कमिश्नर्स एज वेल एज टू द स्टेट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड द सीबीएसई ऑफिशियल्स ऑन व्हाई वी आर सीइंग पोर कंप्लायंस नंबर्स अगेन, इफ एंड दीज नंबर्स मे हैव चेंज्ड, बट 46 लाख taxpayers have filed their GSTR 3B returns for August, 40 lakh taxpayers have successfully filed their GSTR 1 returns for the month of July. You're trying to get a survey done as well, Mr. Adhia, to understand why people have not been able to transition or why they've not necessarily filed. What is the feedback that you're getting from the ground, sir?
We are yet to get the feedback, but that feedback will be only for our internal consumption, because based on the data which we get from that survey, we will come to know what are the teething problems that people find, and if there is any course correction to be done based on that survey ki log kyu return nahi file kar rahe, fir uske aadhar pe hum koi decision le sakte, ye wajah hai ki
okay.
humne ye survey karwa. In the meantime aapne jo aankde diye kuch sudhar hua hai, July 3b abhi tak 55 lakh ho gaye July ke 3b, aur jo aap keh rahe ki August ka jo hai wo nahi, July ka GSTR 1 46 lakhs hai, 40 lakhs nahi hai, और अगस्त का भी करीब करीब 48 लाख से जो 3B है अभी तक, और सितंबर की अगर बात करें तो आज तक करीब 10 लाख रिटर्न आज सुबह 10 बजे तक आ गए थे, और अभी क्योंकि लास्ट 5 डेज आर लेफ्ट तो अभी काफी आ रहे रिटर्न।
ओके सो देयर इज एन इंप्रूवमेंट ऑन दोज नंबर्स। लेट मी स्टार्ट ब्रिंगिंग इन द क्वेश्चंस हियर एंड वी हैव गॉट द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ सीआईआई विद अस शोभना कामिनी, गो अहेड।
First, I'd like to appreciate the fact that you've been so receptive. The government, that's the main thing. We all realize that we're in for a tough time in terms of implementing this, but it's for the good of India. But more than anything else, your receptiveness gives us confidence. But it is a confusing tax for a lot of people. For instance, the e-commerce and the small suppliers that go through them, they have no method of composition at this point. So, for them, they're finding the difficulty of compliance. The second part is people like e-commerce and banking, telecom sector that are in multiple states, and again registering in every state. The compliance burden just really ratchets up, and also people who have a multiplicity of people that travel from state to state. They're saying they used to get an allowance earlier. Now they have to come back. We have to collate everything. So, it's this interstate that is causing a lot of issues for us.
And these are issues that were raised even before the rollout of the GST, Ms. Adhia. So a lot of them returning to the table. If you could respond to that, sir.
देखिए ऐसा है कि एक चीज हमको समझ लेनी चाहिए कि unlike in many other countries where GST is a unitary tax administered by one authority, either central government or state government, हमारे देश में ये dual tax है, dually controlled tax है. पहले तो ये समझ ले. दूसरा कि हम ये कहते हैं कि भाई डेस्टिनेशन बेस्ड टैक्स है, तो जिस स्टेट में कंजम्पशन होता है उस स्टेट को टैक्स मिलना चाहिए. अब वो मेजर करने के लिए हमारे पास और कोई सॉल्यूशन ही नहीं है कि स्टेट वाइज रजिस्ट्रेशन प्रिस्क्राइब करें और स्टेट वाइज लोग टैक्स पे करें. पहले क्या था, पहले हमारे पास वेट था. नो डाउट वेट से इसमें इम्प्रूवमेंट होना चाहिए था, लेकिन वेट के टाइम पे भी गुड्स मैन्युफैक्चरर या गुड्स के जो सेलर थे वो हर स्टेट में रजिस्टर कराते थे. जैसे ये कंपोजिशन वाले हैं वो इंटर स्टेट सेल नहीं कर सकते. अल्दो ये भी गलत फहमी है लोगों में कि कंपोजिशन वाले इंटर स्टेट परचेज भी नहीं कर सकते, बट वो गलत है. इंटर स्टेट वाले मतलब कंपोजिशन डीलर अगर आप है तो किसी भी स्टेट से माल मंगवा सकते हैं विदाउट रजिस्टरिंग देयर और कंपोजिशन में चालू रह सकते हैं, लेकिन बेचने के लिए अभी आपको रजिस्ट्रेशन कराना है, रेगुलर रजिस्ट्रेशन. उसके लिए भी ग्रुप ऑफ मिनिस्टर एक बनाया गया है. दे आर लुकिंग एट दिस ऑप्शन कि अगर कंपोजिशन वाले को भी इंटर स्टेट अलाउ किया जाए तो उसमें क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम होगा.
Ms. Adhia, on the point of multiple registrations, and as I said, that this was an issue that was raised even before the rollout of the GST, so it's, the council knows, the government knows that this is a challenge. Given the fact that it's becoming a compliance burden, and India wants to improve on ease of doing business, sir, is this going to be something that you will push for now with the GST council?
इसका एक ही उपाय है. आप मुझे कोई अगर इस ऑडियंस में से कुछ मुझे उपाय मिले तो I'll be very happy. इसका एक ही उपाय है कि पूरा टैक्स जो है एक अथॉरिटी कलेक्ट करे और बाकी के साथ डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करे. लेकिन वो इंडिया में क्या हो सकता है? ये हमारा जो कोऑपरेटिव फेडरलिज्म का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है और जो स्टेट्स को हमने इंडिपेंडेंट टैक्सिंग के पावर दे रखे हैं, तो स्टेट्स भी तो अपना पावर जो है वो यूज करना चाहेंगे फिस्कल पावर.
सो यू आर सेइंग दैट
सो विल इट बी पॉसिबल इन ए मल्टीफेरियस कंट्री लाइक इंडिया कि द स्टेट्स लेट गो देयर फिस्कल पावर्स इन फेवर ऑफ single authority? That is the only question we have to answer. If that happens, then there will be simplest tax.
Well, I guess the GST Council, which is a representation of states as well, will need to look into this issue. Ajay Sriram, go ahead, sir.
Thank you. I must congratulate you and your team on such smooth implementation of 22 meetings all by consensus. I think that's absolutely fantastic. So I just want to mention that factually GST is a disruptive tax. It is a major change from the system the Indian business people have been attuned to for the last many years. My request is how to make it simpler. I think if you look on a scale of 1 to 10, our objective would be to reach 8-9 in due course of time. I think the changes in the last 10 days which you brought about are remarkable. That's brought us down to 4-5. But maybe can we come down to 2-3 as a starting point? And a couple of things, sir. One is like, for instance, there's a tax on the advances paid. That is an issue which is affecting many industries. Then in the service sector again, where earlier on the number of returns they had to file was very low. Today they have to go state-wise. That's again a very complex situation. And the many small people on advances, for instance, 1.5 crores, which is the limit, can that be looked at higher? And the other 2 points to request, what you've done on reverse charge. and what you've done on this e-way bill till January and March. Kindly look at extending that a little more, giving more leeway so that people can adjust to a system. That is my request to you.
Some have in fact said that don't just suspend the reverse charge mechanism, but drop it altogether and drop e-way bill altogether as well.
Better we go back to wet regime.
Exactly. I knew that was going to be your response, sir. But on the point that Mr. Sriram raised, sir, on what more we can expect in terms of ease of doing business.
We are at it. We want to improve. I want your suggestions on it. If there is any such obnoxious provision of the law which you think is coming in the way of ease of doing business, we will look at it. We have no problem. But to say that 9-4 and e-way bill should be done away with is actually returning back to the old system of taxation. What is newness in GST then? What is newness? Because ultimately it's a new tax in which it's very difficult for anybody to evade taxes. If we have a parallel economy existing with the honest taxpayers, it's going to be having disastrous effect on the honest people.
Okay.
Everybody will turn to the parallel economy then. Do we want to really leave so many loopholes for parallel economy to exist? Now, these are the hard questions we have to answer.
Sure. Speaking of hard questions, sir, and before I take a break, I'm going to ask you, what about the list of items under the 28% bracket, because we've already seen a significant number of items where the rate revision has already taken place. The announcements and the notifications have come in from the GST Council. Can we expect a substantial pruning of the number of items in the 28% bracket, sir?
Dekhiye, it is required. I agree with you, you know, because the fitment of rate which has happened is mainly based on the excise duty rate on that item and the VAT rate on that item. Now, there are industries where 95% of the production used to take place in MSME, and all of them used to avail of 1.5 crore excise duty exemption. That means that the excise rate we have taken for that item is only theoretical in nature. And actually, we have done a substantial increase in that item rate, in the rate of that item. So that way, it is being pointed out that it's a theoretical rate that we have derived.
Okay.
So there is a need for rationalization. Instead of doing a piecemeal reduction here and there, we do need to look at the entire list of 28%.
Okay.
But it will be done based on the principles which are now framed in the approach paper, which has been approved by the council. Certain principles have been derived. And based on that approach paper, the fitment committee will do its job and come back to the council. And also, it will have to derive the figure of revenue loss for that. Now, this exercise is going to be done. And there is a definitely future scope for rationalization.
Would it be as early as the next meeting of the GST Council, Mr.
Adhia? I can't say that. But we'll try our best, because we have been always speedier than what you expect us to be. But we will sort of try and do it as early as possible.
So the two guiding principles, sir, one was the principle of equivalence when you were arriving at rates. Where does that now stand? And also on this business of revenue neutrality, because you've already seen a significant number of items where the rate has been revised downwards. If you're going to be pruning rates or rationalizing rates even further, what happens then to revenue neutrality, sir?
That's what the fitment committee will have to look at, the exact figure of how much revenue did we get in that item from excise duty and VAT earlier. Now, that's a detailed exercise they have to do before we agree to any further wholesale reduction of rates. And if we find that revenue reduction is going to be too much, we may have to do it in stages then.
You may have to do it in stages. All right, on that note, we'll take a first commercial break. But when we return, we continue our question and answer session here with the Revenue Secretary. Dekhte rahiye CNBC TV18 or CNBC Awaaz. Vapas aa rahe hain break ke baad. Welcome back. You're watching our GST Town Hall here from the headquarters of the Confederation of Indian Industry. We're in conversation with the Revenue Secretary. Industry posing tough questions that he's trying to bat effectively. But Ms. Adhia, more questions coming here from this time the restaurant sector. Go ahead with your questions.
Good evening, sir. My name is Prateek Pota. I'm from Jubilant Foodworks. My question is as follows. We believe that the group of ministers is discussing currently the possibility of reducing GST on AC restaurants from 18% to 12%. We would strongly welcome such a move because it would help make dining out more affordable, expand the QSR in the dining in market, and help drive job creation. However, we are also concerned to note, sir, that there is some debate happening on removal of input tax credit. And so that, we believe, would drive up costs significantly for the industry and would, even if partially passed on, lead to as much as 6 to 8% price increase, defeating the entire purpose of driving affordability. So I wanted your perspective on that, sir, and your point of view.
Well, the group of ministers is looking at all the options and they are studying the subject, and we'll come to know when they give some recommendation.
So the GOM actually met yesterday, but I believe that yesterday there was no decision that was taken. There is another meeting of the group of ministers that is expected on the 29th of October. So should we expect that the GOM's recommendations will be taken to the council when it next meets on the 9th and 10th of October?
Of course, that's the idea. They have to give their report before the meeting of the next GST council.
But do you believe that there is merit in seeking a reduction of the rates from 18% to 12%?
Well, at a time when the
state has some seem to suggest that in principle in the last meeting of the GST council, that was what the agreement was.
No, actually there was no agreement, and that's why the GOM was asked to work on it. There were various options. And so GOM, when the GOM is working on it, I would not like to give any personal opinion on this.
Okay. All right. So that's a GOM that's already looking into these issues. Let me bring in another question here. And I know you've been getting a lot of this the questions related to this particular issue of car leasing. Go ahead.
Hi. This is Pushpendra Jindal. And I have a question here regarding corporate car lease schemes. I appreciate that you've reduced, you've taken our case and given a 35% abatement. But, sir, we are still stuck. I mean, the new cars which are getting leased after 1st of August, after 1st of July, they are paying almost the same EMI which you would have paid in the last year. But the EMIs for the people who have been in the transition phase, that is still higher by about 27%, even after the abatement. And similarly, the case for the foreclosures, because the input tax credit has been taken on the new leases which are getting signed. So ideally, we are unfairly treated.
Can they expect for more relief, sir, or the abatement that has been provided, is that it?
Look, you know, earlier you used to pay about 15% VAT on the lease amount. Now we have said ki whatever is the rate of duty on that particular product, car for example, if it is a small car then you would be paying normally 29%. And if it's a big car, it would be 43% or 45%. And we have given an abatement of 35%, which means you are saying now for big car, it may be 27%. But for small car, it is almost close to what they were paying. So we have given a big relief to small car people as far as that is concerned. And this figure of 35% was decided by the council consciously. I don't see any reason now whether we can
review that
so soon.
Okay. But sir, just on the issue of cars, and this is a representation that the auto sector has also made to government, is there any possibility, sir, of a reduction in the compensation cess which was hiked by the council, because that's the representation that industry has made to you?
I don't think we should be doing this, you know. Ek mahine mein kata diya, fir bada diya, fir kata diya.
Toh bada diya, ek mahine mein katane mein dikkat ho rahi hai, sir.
जब हमने बढ़ाया तब आप लोगों ने ये बोला बार बार चेंज नहीं करना चाहिए अब फिर से बोल रहे हैं कि बार बार चेंज करो घटाओ
ओके ऑल राइट सो दैट्स वेरी क्लियर द रेवेन्यू सेक्रेटरी देयर सेइंग दैट डोंट एक्सपेक्ट अ कट एज फार एज द कंपनसेशन सेस इज कंसर्नड एट लीस्ट फॉर द ऑटो सेक्टर गौतम नायर हियर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द टेक्सटाइल सेक्टर एंड द एक्सपोर्ट सेक्टर गौतम गो अहेड
सर आई रिप्रेजेंट स्पेसिफिकली द अपैरल एक्सपोर्ट इंडस्ट्री एंड आई स्पीक ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर ओवर 8000 मेंबर्स 90% ऑफ हुम आर इन द एमएसएमई सेक्टर As you probably know, sir, along with textile, we are the largest employment in India after agriculture. Our industry currently employs about 13 million workers, of whom 70% are women. So we like to think it's an industry of some special significance. Generally speaking, our members, mainly the small-scale members, have been hit hard by the GST introduction in terms of adjusting to a new procedure, in terms of the working capital lockup, in terms of just understanding the complexity of GST laws. Having said that, on behalf of the sector, we welcome it wholeheartedly. We are especially thankful to government for the changes you have made, specifically with reference to MSME and specifically with reference to exports. There are three key problems which remain for us, sir. By far the most important problem is after October 1st, duty drawback and ROSL have come down by over 70% on grounds that this is being subsumed by GST. Sir, the facts of the matter are a little different. Sourcing shift away from China. And that has the potential of creating a huge number of jobs and creating, getting in great foreign exchange for India. It's especially important at this stage that we don't create any dislocation for our industry. We are cognizant of the fact that you have referred it to the matter being referred to the drawback committee. We only request that a decision from the drawback committee we got quickly. We've been asking for it for 3 months, sir, and it be implemented with retrospective effect from 1st October. The second smaller point is that currently we pay, currently in the last GST Council meeting, IGST has been removed on advanced licenses where there was a basic custom duty of zero. AEPC issues a duty-free license for import of trims, which is very, very important for our exporters. For some reason, perhaps by oversight, that has not been included in the list of advanced licenses. So currently, we still are required to pay 18% IGST on that. That may kindly be considered. And finally, we have a small problem that, again, probably by oversight, there's a GST charged on freight, not if the shipment is freight collect, only if the shipment is freight prepaid. Possibly an anomaly, but it acts as a double whammy for our exporters because freight prepaid is normally like a penalty. So you're already paying a penalty perhaps because of a late delivery, mm-hmm. and then you pay GST on top of that.
So three specific issues, Ms. Adhia, would you like to comment?
Well, as far as the first two suggestions, they are suggestions. First two things are suggestions only. We look at their suggestions. The third one, I don't think we have created any disparity between freight paid by the importer or by the exporter. We have not created any disparity.
On freight collect, there is no GST.
Even
when I import goods, there is no GST. But if I'm exporting goods and the freight is being prepaid, we pay GST on it.
No, if I remember it correctly, we have designed it in such a way that there is a parity between both. But I'll look at it. If there is any disparity, you can send it to us. We will look at it.
Our key problem is drawback and ROSL.
Drawback and ROSL, you know, look, drawback is now replaced by seamless flow of input tax credit availment. Now, ultimately, drawback was in lieu of not getting input tax credit. Now you're getting seamless input tax credit. So that is one. As far as ROSL is concerned, there are some extra demands which have come. Now, it has been referred to the drawback committee. Drawback
right.
committee will come out with its recommendation. We'll look at it.
Embedded in block taxes, they're also going to be reimbursed through the drawback and ROSL route?
No. That is the recommendation we have asked. No?
So you're waiting for the drawback
committee. ROSL, some of the embedded taxes.
So just a quick question on exporters. In the last meeting of the GST Council, some of those issues were addressed. In our conversation with state finance ministers, the suggestion seems to be that some more substantive issues related to the export sector are likely to be taken up in the next meeting of the GST Council. Can you give us some sense of what is pending now from the wish list that exporters have put forward to you that will address the working capital issues and the other issues that they've faced?
Well, I think there are no more issues which are left because we are virtually shifting to the pre-GST position,
right.
wherein they are not supposed to pay any taxes on import. IGST exemption is already given. The notification is issued on Friday. But for other suppliers who are supplying to exporters, deemed export notification is yet to be issued, which will be done by today, hopefully, or maybe tomorrow, latest. And the merchant exporters, 1% notification, that will be coming out today or tomorrow. So these are the only two notifications which are left out. We'll be doing it very shortly. But after that, if there are any other issues of exporters, we'll be happy to look at
that. So the process of refunds has also started, at least for the month of July. Can you give us some sense of the kind of refunds that we're expecting?
Dekhiye, there are two, three kinds of refunds on export. One is for people jo export ke saath IGST pay karte hai. They prefer to pay IGST on export. July mein karib 600 crore aaye the aise aur August mein 900 crore.
Okay.
Inka zaruri hai ke turant mil jaye unko. So that window we have opened and refund has started going. I'm sure ki by end of this month, both July and August, we should be able to finish that
refund process. Okay, that's good news. Chandrajit Banerjee, go ahead.
Dr. Adhia, first of all, congratulations and thank you very much for whenever we have come to you on specific issues, you have always sorted it out in a very, very tight time frames and not even waited sometimes whenever it's not required to wait for the GST Council meetings. Having said that, my question is more on the overall economy issue and trying to relate GST to it. And here is where, we have certain exemptions and where in certain sectors, say for one sector that I'd like to pick up is the real estate sector. And there, where the input costs seem to be going up, say for instance, be it cement, be it other paints, etc., which is really becoming very difficult in terms of costings for the real estate sector, so to say. And if, especially with the government's focus on the affordable housing, etc., is it when does one see a time frame of these exceptions getting included? And the follow-up is not just the real estate sector, but what about the others which has been left out, be it hydrocarbons or other sectors?
Well, when it comes to real estate being included, what it means is that you should be given a seamless credit of any taxes you pay on the real estate project in your business also. Now for that to happen, we have to start taxing it from land itself. Land has to be part of GST.
Right.
Now there are several issues connected with that. Also the issue of whether you want to put an extra GST on real estate while continuing with the stamp duty. This is one scenario.
Yes.
Now, stamp duty is a big source of income for many state governments.
Yes.
And that is something which is exclusively enjoyed by states.
So then realistically, sir, because once again, this sort of clamor that bring petroleum under GST, bring real estate under GST, and the finance minister seems to be suggesting that this may in fact be taken up at the next council meeting. So is that a realistic expectation that we could see forward movement on both real estate as well as petroleum moving into the GST regime anytime soon?
Even trying to understand what the issue is also a forward movement.
So that's where it is.
So
that's where
to,
it is. Okay.
We need to discuss at least. So finance minister has rightly said so, that we'll take up these issues, at least brainstorm, understand the various facets of this decision, and then take a view about it. Even taking a view that, okay, we'll reconsider after 6 months is also a view.
So we should not hold our breath on either real estate or petroleum being brought under the ambit of the GST
anytime soon.
No, we need to understand. Anytime soon.
We need to have an informed debate also in the society.
Yeah.
Let's all discuss about it. What are the various angles? And I already see, after the FMS said, I see a lot of newspaper articles coming on this subject.
Yes.
So it makes the debate more informed.
No, you're absolutely right. In fact, state FMs like the Delhi Finance Minister has also written and has been consistently asking for real estate to be brought under the GST ambit. But we've got many more questions here. Hari, go ahead.
Sir, coming back to compliance again, so I do agree, sir, from where we started in August, GSTM has stabilized a lot. But sir, the issues are still not gone. Even on GSTR1, we have sent mails to your own email ID and Mr. Arjun's OSD's email ID, where on 26 data that was submitted 26th of September, the data was in process with no response till 3rd of October. There was panic because 3rd of October, people beyond 100 crores had to file. But people who couldn't resolve the problem by that, for whatever reasons, had to pay penalty the next day. So those is what people are asking for, a kind of a waiver, because it's of no fault of the people who submitted data which didn't get processed. And this happened both through GSTR1 utility and also happened through what ASP GSPs did. Again, GSTR2, sir, it has started from 11th. The integration is still not functioning smoothly, sir. And we've got 25th October is the day, which this week, which is going to be a truncated week because of Diwali, sir. So I really feel I don't know how many will be able to file by 25th or how many will be able to file by 31st, because sir, this is even more complex than GSTR1, because nobody will know till he downloads the GSTR2A as to what the matching is.
Yeah.
So the first month is going to be a very painful month. So my only request is, sir, you've done a fantastic job by quarterly return for composition dealers and up to 1 crore. So the load on the GST system is over. But like you very rightly said, 90% are those people, but the real volume is coming for the balance.
Yeah.
And which are in lakhs of transactions. And there, the pain still continues to remain, sir.
Look, we realized this right in the beginning. If you remember in Hyderabad meeting itself, last meeting, we decided that the first cycle of GSTR 1, 2, 3, we will give a big, big time for that, long rope. And that's why we gave so much of time for filing of GSTR 1, so that we could sort out those issues. GST R2 also we have got 20 days. And if you point out what the problems are, we'll tell GSTN to improve upon it. Mm. So that we have enough time for all of us and without being assailed about
October,
it.
October 25th, is that likely to be extended?
31st.
October 25th is...
For the large companies.
Yeah. Large companies, yes.
Because of the
Diwali. For the large companies.
Basically, this is what we transparently...
Yeah. Yeah.
No. Sir, I have sent you mails. Today also we have sent mails about the issues people are facing.
Okay.
So that, and let me tell you, with due respect to GSTN, they are responsive. Even at the level of Mr. Prakash Kumar, he responds. You know, but there is, it's a software. After all, you are still using it for the first time.
We agree. Yeah. It's a learning for us. It's a learning for you also. Yeah. It's a learning for all of us.
Yeah.
But as long as there is a desire to improve,
sure.
As long as there is a quickness in attending to your problems, there is no problem. So please keep sending those suggestions to us and we will look at it, you know.
Okay. Well, Mr. Adhia, they are saying that the government will look into the issues that have been faced on the GSTN, but we will need to take another break here on CNBC TV18. But do come back to us as we continue our Q&A session here with the Revenue Secretary. And if you've got questions, tweet us right away, GST Town Hall. That's the hashtag. Come right back. CNBC TV 18 CII GST Town Hall. We're in conversation with the Revenue Secretary Hasmukh Adhia. Sir, there's lots of questions here for you, but let me kickstart by asking you about the change as far as the devolution calendar is concerned, because we're given to understand that states have raised some concerns about that. The center has responded saying that states must also align themselves to new tax reality, as well as to the fact that you are going to face some uncertainty on the revenue front, and hence they must also be sensitive to what the center is facing at this point in time. What is the view on that, sir? Are we expecting any change, not just in the schedule of payment, but also in the quantum itself?
Well, actually, devolution of devolution of tax money is not within my department. It is with the Department of Expenditure or maybe the. The question is ki abhi jo 15 ke badle mein first tarikh ka kiya hai devolution ka calendar. उसके पीछे वजह यह है कि पहले हमारी एक्साइज और सर्विस टैक्स की इनकम 7 तारीख तक आ जाती थी, अब हमको 20 तारीख तक वेट करना पड़ता है. सो दैट इज द मेन रीजन, देयर इज अ डिले ऑफ 15 डेज इन दैट. सो दैट्स व्हाई द कैलेंडर मस्ट हैव बीन चेंज्ड, बट I'm not the right person to answer
that
question.
All right, let me bring in more questions. Here's one from the aviation sector. Amber Dubey, go ahead.
नमस्कार, मेरा नाम अंबर दुबे है. मैं द वाइस चेयरमैन ऑफ सीआई एविएशन कमेटी. सर, ये इस वक्त हमारा फोकस सबसे ज्यादा जीडीपी ग्रोथ और जॉब ग्रोथ पे है, और ये एविएशन दोनों चीजें दे रहा है. अब अनफॉर्चुनेट पार्ट ये हो रहा है कि जबकि एविएशन 14-16% से ग्रो कर रहा है, एयरक्राफ्ट बहुत सारे आ रहे हैं, बट रिपेयर्स जो हैं वो सब हम बाहर शिफ्ट हो गए. सिर्फ 10% एयरक्राफ्ट का रिपेयर्स यहाँ होते हैं, 90% हम उसको सिंगापुर, कोलंबो और गल्फ में भेज देते हैं. प्रॉब्लम दूसरी ये हो रही है कि सर, पहले जो इंपोर्ट ऑफ सर्विस पार्ट्स थे, जैसे एयरक्राफ्ट इंजन्स हो गए, सील्स, गैसकेट्स एक्सेट्रा, लैंडिंग गियर्स, उस पर पहले कोई जीएसटी नहीं था, उस पर अब 18-28% जीएसटी हो गया. तो एयरलाइंस की भी हालत खराब है, और जो हमारे मेंटेनेंस रिपेयर एंटिटीज हैं वो बंद हो रही हैं. लास्ट पार्ट ये सर, ये जो मैरीटाइम में आपने एक बहुत अच्छा काम किया, बंकर ऑयल पर आपने 18% जीएसटी लगा के उसको आप है ना इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट भी दे रहे हैं. सो फ्रॉम ऑल साइड्स वी हैव गॉट स्क्वीज, सो प्लीज सर, इफ यू कैन कंसीडर सम रिलीफ.
Mr. Adhia, is there scope here at all as far as the aviation sector is concerned for any relief, sir? This is a big growth sector for us.
No, every sector in India is a growth sector. India has got an unlimited growth opportunity. But the question is ki to your, it's out of your 3 points, can I ask you a question that relating to your point number 2 and 3, is there any change vis-a-vis pre-GST now?
No, sir. Dekhi, pahle to import...
There is no change. There is absolutely no change pre-GST and now. As far as the rate of taxation on aviation turbine fuel is concerned, and as far as not giving you input tax credit of other than services in economic class is concerned.
सर, मैं एक लाइव आपको एक्चुअल
एविडेंस. इकोनॉमिक क्लास इट हैज गॉन डाउन फ्रॉम 6% टू 5%.
सर, 6% कर दीजिए सर,
6 से 5 हो गया ना,
बढ़ा दीजिए. और हमें
बट पहले आपको मिल रहा था क्या इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट?
नहीं, मैं उसका एक लाइव एग्जांपल
नहीं मिल रहा था आपको.
नहीं सर, मैं आपको एविडेंस दे रहा हूँ सर. महाराष्ट्र देखिए,
नो चेंज विजाविज प्री जीएसटी एंड नाउ, बोथ इन एविएशन टर्बाइन फ्यूल और इन योर सर्विस टैक्स रेट.
30 सेकंड दे दिए तो मैं प्रमाण दे देता हूँ आपको. सर, महाराष्ट्र में इतना बॉम्बे में हमारा जो एमआरओ इंडस्ट्री है, जूहू और छत्रपति शिवाजी एयरपोर्ट पे, वहां पर सर, और नागपुर में भी जो बहुत बड़ा सेंटर बन रहा है
वो फर्स्ट पॉइंट है. एमआरओ, एमआरओ वाला आपका पहला पॉइंट है. आपके तीन डिमांड थे, एक एमआरओ वाली थी, एक थी आपकी कि भाई एविएशन टर्बाइन फ्यूल
इंजन वापस आ रहे हैं सर, वो सब स्टक है और आजकल वैसे भी आप देख रहे हैं कुछ एयरलाइंस के इंजन काफी
एमआरओ इज अ डिफरेंट इशू, विल लुक एट इट यू नो.
बस उतना काफी, थैंक यू सो मच.
एमआरओ विल लुक एट इट.
द एमआरओ इशू इज समथिंग दैट द रेवेन्यू सेक्रेटरी इज विलिंग टू लुक एट. दीपक गर्ग, गो अहेड.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर. सर दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच इंपैक्ट्स नॉट जस्ट बिजनेसेस बट लैक्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज. This is on taxation of or liability of GST on employee perks. There is a lot of confusion on that. There was first a press release issued by CBEC in the first week of July, second week of July, clarifying that these would not be taxed. And then subsequently on 28th of August in FAQs, they've said that the fringe benefits which are given to the employees, even if without consideration, would be liable to GST. Now, this is an area which has now changed from service tax regime to the GST regime because employer-employee relationship has been deemed to be a related party. So therefore, any supply by an employer to an employee becomes taxable even in the absence of consideration. So this issue impacts a large number of employees, sir, if we end up taxing the perquisites which are given by the companies to the employees. So the request would be, sir, to give complete clarity on this issue after having thinking through. It impacts us as a business, it impacts me as an employee. So
sir, what is that, what does that smile mean, sir? You're smiling through that question.
Because there is a complete clarity on this issue. There is no lack of clarity on this. We have clearly said that if it is a employer-employee relationship which is enshrined in the contract, we have no problem. But out of a blue, suppose the owner is very happy and says, okay, tomorrow is Diwali, all of you will get 1 lakh rupees each, you know. Now, that's not a part of the contract. If in the original contract you had said, yes, you will be eligible to get A, B, C, D, E, F, Z, then no problem,
correct.
You get it.
You're right. This is what was
I mean, including all the perks. All the perks are also not part of GST. So it's not that. So but suddenly some favor is done out of turn and not a part of the regular contract. रेगुलर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में आप जो मर्जी पॉक्स लिखवा दीजिए, हमें कोई दिक्कत नहीं.
बिल्कुल सर, दिस वाज प्रिसाइसली व्हाट वाज क्लैरिफाइड इन द प्रेस
रिलीज,
बट इज दैट एफएक्यू ऑफ 28th ऑफ जुलाई व्हिच हैज क्रिएटेड द डाउट्स.
व्हाट डिड द एफएक्यू से?
द एफएक्यू, आई हैव इट इफ यू वांट, आई कैन रीड.
व्हाट डज इट से?
इट सेज दैट द फ्रिंज बेनिफिट्स गिवन बाय द एम्प्लॉयर टू द एम्प्लॉयर वुड बी टैक्सेबल.
फ्रिंज मींस व्हिच इज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. फ्रिंज मींस अदर देन दैट, यू नो. आई थिंक सो,
वी टेक दैट एज अ क्लैरिफिकेशन. आई विश
यू कैन क्लैरिफाई, दे कैन क्लैरिफाई, यू नो, दे आर अदर देन. नो नो नो. Then the word used may be
working committee members. I mean, in the conversation, you know, I have to Upendra and all. That's what they have maintained. I agree this FAQ did create a doubt in people's mind.
That we can clarify.
But as long as it's contractually there in your letter of employment,
part of the contract, any amount of perquisite.
So as long as it's part of the contract, it's okay, and it won't invite Ms. Adhia's ire. Yes, go ahead.
Sir. Sir Sunil Vachani from Dixon Technologies. I also co-chair the ICT committee. Sir, a lot of members are facing the issue of inverted duty structure, wherein the duty on inputs is more than the outputs. Is there a way that we can, solve this problem by bringing it at par? And in the interim, is there a, you know, time-bound mechanism for refund of the excess GST that the members are accumulating?
Well, ideally, it should not happen that there is an inverted duty structure. But fortunately, we've given this option that if there is any inverted duty structure, you can get the refund of taxes paid on inputs. If we do this exercise of relooking at all the rates, in which one of the criteria could be that on intermediate there should not be a rate of 28%. Mm. Now, this could be one criteria.
Mm.
So that should bring down, you know, if that is the rate, that is the criteria which is taken into account, that should bring down the duty inversion cases. But still in extreme cases, like for example, tractor, where the tractor rate is 12%, the inputs are 28%, or fertilizer, for that matter, where the final output is 5%, while input chemicals may be at 18%. Mm. Now, these are the cases which are inevitable, you know. But
Are there more cases where such anomalies of the inverted duty structure being reviewed, sir, currently?
There are two ways of dealing with it. One is key just to expedite the refund, which we are trying to do. And we'll try and see. I agree that so far that refund mechanism is not yet ready. But yes, as early as possible, we'll make it available. Our RFD1, the regular refund form, will be available on 20th of November, as per the present calendar.
Well,
and after that, it should start flowing. But in the meantime, this exercise of relooking at all the rates will also help.
Very quickly, we're running out of time. Very quickly, your question.
Sir, I'm representing from the leather industry. I'm counsel for leather exports, vice chairman. My name is Pierre Akil Ahmed. Sir, I met you on the 19th September and also on the 6th October. I have to really compliment and thank the government and for giving a big relief that recently was announced on the 6th on the advanced license script and the also on the authorization system. So we're very thankful to you, sir, on that. As you know, sir, our also industry is the MSME unit, and most of the exporters have registered under the MSME unit. So that on the leather goods and the garments, the leather garments, which is at the most highest GST rate, which we also represented to you, sir. If you could look into that, it will be great helpful, because leather bags is very, very common today used among women, and also the, you know, the leather goods, which is the highest. The other product we are, you know, we have also made representation. Thank you, sir.
Well, as he's already pointed out, that that he's looking at a whole bunch of rates, Mr. Somani, very quickly, sir, go ahead.
Sir, thank you for coming to CII. A lot of questions that you've already touched upon, so I don't want to take that. But there's one particular question that I would like to ask you, is specifically to the ceramic industry. We use RLNG, natural gas, and we're now paying 15% on local, when you're buying local. Where is the...
Which industry?
Ceramic.
Which state?
All the states were doing. There's a central government's notification to bring it to all states to say that it has to become revenue neutral. Most 5 states have done it, but many states haven't, like Haryana hasn't. And we've gone to seen them to say that up to 6%, if you charge, it is revenue neutral. And this is really hurting the industry, sir.
No, I would like to know, because the general consensus in the council member was that we should not hit the manufacturing sector by high VAT on LNG. So most states agreed we will keep it in the range of 5 or 6%.
Exactly.
So all the major states have already made it 5 or 6. But if there are states which have not done it and they are still keeping it at 15%, we would like to...
Sir, can I come and give it to you?
You can just send me a letter and...
Yeah, I will do it.
Sure.
Because that's very important. It's hurting us.
Rahul, go ahead very quickly.
So electricity is outside the ambit of GST. While under Chapter 84-85, 5% rate is to be applied on all equipment on solar power generating plants. But there is no operational clarity on how this has to be availed, especially since many of some goods are charged at higher rates in other industries. I'll give you an example. 18% for capital goods such as inverters and 28% for cables and batteries. So it's similar to what Mr. Vachani was saying. But in this case, the use is different. So for different use, there are different prices which are specified. So those rates for solar or similar industries should be unified. That would be my suggestion.
Well, solar industry has been given a special dispensation of 5%. Now, if you are trying to tell me that any input which goes into solar panels or solar industry should be also taxed at 5%, there will be too much, because there will be a lot of revenue loss for that. Those items cannot be at 5%. So we have issued some clarification about it. Okay, what are the items which would be counted for solar systems, part of solar system, and which are the standalone items on which the normal rate of duty will apply. Hmm. So we have given some clarification recently.
Okay.
You may like to get hold of that clarification.
Okay. One final question here from the lady on the healthcare sector. Sir, represent the CII Healthcare Committee, and send a very laudable step. Healthcare services are exempt from GST, and the idea was, it's been to benefit the customer, the consumer. But sir, the procurement by the sector is largely taxable, and therefore the consumer is really not benefiting under the scheme. Our very humble suggestion, sir, for your consideration is that if we are able to, you know, all the procurements going to health sector, we are able to put them under zero rated, and then, sir, the refund of input taxes, the benefit will go as reduced prices to the consumer. We'd love to hear from you on this.
No, that's a demand that you want to make, but the question is, pre-GST and post-GST, there is no further hitting the sector, health sector.
Yes.
Pre-GST and post-GST, there is no change. Because pre-GST also, there was no service tax of 15% on the health sector. And at the same time, you used to pay VAT and excise duty on all the inputs which hospitals used to acquire, all the inputs, consumables or whatever inputs, or furniture or whatever you used to buy.
But
so there is no change in the position. it's a different, as far as zero rating demand is concerned, we are not in favor of starting the zero rating demand for any domestic sector. Zero rating is only for export. And at that rate, though, we will be losing revenue like hell. Because when, I mean, exemption is a better option for us.
Exemption is a better option than zero, than
otherwise,
zero rating.
Otherwise, you can agree, if health sector agrees, to put us in 18% standard service tax.
Do you agree?
And we can then, you know, give you all the input tax credit of goods and services.
So it's just that all the supplies, the taxes have gone up. So they've piled on as indirect taxes heavily on the chain. The supplies, the procurements, there the taxes have all gone up, whether it's the beds or, you know, all the supplies to the healthcare.
I don't think we have really increased taxes on any item.
No, those items have gone up, sir, and the net impact is quite high.
Maybe
it's a good idea to share that with the Revenue Secretary offline.
Then the inflation rate should have gone up quite a bit.
We're completely out of time. I know we have many more questions here for the Revenue Secretary. We just have to get him back again, sir, and we hope that you will join us again. But let me ask you finally, Ms. Adhia, in terms of the state of the economy, the impact of the GST on the state of the economy, what is the assessment, sir? How much longer do you believe that this will continue to have a disruptive impact on the economy? The process of destocking and restocking is now underway. What is the assessment as far as the GST impact on the economy itself is concerned, sir?
I'm not an economist, but then I do hope the last quarter figure was only one of its, it was just one off case, it was not a regular trend.
Mm.
And that happened because of destocking, as all of us know. Now, already some numbers are out, this quarter looks to be better. And I do hope that the effect of GST is as less as possible, it is minimal. And everybody is now predicting, all the economists, I'm not an economist, all the economists are predicting a very good number for India, you know, ranging from 6.7 to 7.3 or something like that, when the year ends. So that should be possible. I only go with them. I don't have my personal assessment of the figure. Thank you.
Well, what you can assure us is that the council as well as the government is receptive and open to making more changes as and when is necessary. And that's something that is the clear, unequivocal assurance here coming in from the Revenue Secretary. Many thanks, sir, for joining us here at the CNBC TV18 CII GST Town Hall. Thank you very much to our participants for joining us here today. From all of us here, goodbye. Many thanks for watching.